mirrors on the ceiling, the water bed, yeah?
No, no.
Hello and welcome to day four, the last day of the Olympic Oval Finale in Canada Cup 4. Some great racing ahead of us today. First up, this is the ladies 1500 meter, starting with a single pair as our first race of the day. This is Isabel Weidman from Ontario in the inner lane and Roxanne van Hemert from the Netherlands in the outer. They're underway in this 1500 meter 3 3/4 lap race. As the skaters go through this long 300 meter opener, Van Hemert opening a big lead on Weidman. Weidman has the legs to finish strong though. Van Hemert's opener 25.6. That's a quick opener. 27.3 for Weidman. So Weidman has her work cut out for her to catch her pair. As they come through, two laps remaining. Van Hemert, lap time. 28.4, 29.3 for Weidman. .1500 meter is a long sprint, a pure middle distance race. Most skaters will skate out almost as fast as they can, maybe 95%, and try to hold that pace to the end. Here comes Van Hemert, her lap time, 30.53, 30.29 for Weidman. Weidman's gaining ground. 2.5 seconds back, it's probably too little too late. As Weidman enters that outer corner, and Hemert on the inner. Down the home stretch, here comes Isabel Weidman. Can she catch Van Hemert? Van Hemert will take it, though. 1:58.03, her final time. Weidman, 1:58.21. As we have a look at our next race, this is Paige Schwartzberg from the United States in the inner lane. Josie Spence from BC in the outer. Starting behind them, Beatrice Lamarche from Quebec and Rining Tian from China. This is Schwartzberg and Spence underway in this 1500 meter race. They are the first pair. So Schwartzberg and Spence, their openers, 25.8 for Schwartzberg, Spence 26.9. As our second pair is now underway into the home stretch. Three laps to go for Beatrice Lamarche and Rining Tian. Their opening splits, 25.7 for Tian, 26.1 for Lamarche. They cross over on the backstretch. Our first pair is now through 700 meters. Their lap times, 28.7 for Schwartzberg, 29.5 for Spence. Pay attention to each lap time. Each lap should be about 1 second slower than the previous lap if the skaters are on a good race. This is the bell lap now for Schwartzberg and Spence. 30.3 for Schwartzberg, 30.7 for Spence. Spence can finish strong as well. Let's see if she can catch her pair. As they cross over one last time, Lamarche and Tian now on their last lap. Mid 30 second laps for both skaters. They are neck and neck. As Schwartzberg will hold her lead right to the line, her final time, 1:57.36. That takes the top spot in the leaderboard, 1:59.35 for Spence. As Tian and Lamarche now come to the line. 1:57.25 for Rining Tian, beating Paige Schwartzberg by a little bit. Lamarche, 1:58.13. That is a personal best for Beatrice Lamarche, 1:58. First time under 1:59. This is our third quartet. Sugar Todd from the United States in the inner lane, and Carrie Morrison from Ontario in the outer. Starting behind them is Maddie Pierman from Alberta and Aaron Bartlett from the United States. Sugar Todd on the inner lane, her opening split, 25-6, that's the fastest one of the day, 25-8 for Carrie Morrison. Two quick openers for Morrison and Todd. As Pierman comes through, 26-4, 26-5 for Bartlett. So Carrie Morrison opening very quick with the sprinter, Sugar Todd. Let's see if she can keep pace. Morrison's lap time, 28-1. She's just under the pace set by Rining Tian at this point of the race. Sugar Todd, 28-81. As Pierman and Bartlett will come through. Pierman's leading the way in that pair. 29-1 her lap time, 29-3 for Bartlett. So Pierman and Bartlett just a bit off the pace of Todd and Morrison. As Todd and Morrison are now on their last lap. They're neck and neck. Morrison, 30.3 for Sugar Todd. Morrison's going to set up a big draft on this backstretch with one lap to go in this 1,500-meter race. Pierman and Bartlett hear the bell. One to go for them. 30.4 for Pierman. Bartlett, 31.3. As Carrie Morrison will lead Sugar Todd into this final straightaway. Morrison skating to the line, her final time, 1:57.13. That takes the top spot, Sugar Todd, 1:57.81. What a race from Carrie Morrison. As Maddie Pierman comes through, 1:58.73, her final time, 2:01.91 for Bartlett. Up next, we have Rebecca Bradford from the U.S. in the inner lane. She's racing Victoria Spence from B.C. in the outer. Starting behind them is Femke Marcus from Norway, from the Netherlands, and Noemi Fisse from Quebec. So Spence and Bradford underway now. Long race ahead of these two skaters. 3 3/4 laps as Marcus and Fisse start. Victoria Spence, who skated a personal best in her 5,000 meter yesterday, looking for another PB here. It's a 1:59. See if she can skate under 1:59 in this 15 here. As these two skaters come through, Fisse and Marcus, opening split, 25-8 for Fisse, 27-3 for Marcus. As Bradford leads Spence through 700 meters, 28-8 her lap time, 30.4 for Spence. So Rebecca Bradford will be aiming to skate under 30 seconds on her next lap. Let's pay attention to those lap times. Noemi Fisse comes through 29.4 her lap time, 30.1 for Marcus. Bell lap now for Bradford, 30.92. That's a 2 second drop off. Victoria Spence, 31.5. 1 second off for Victoria Spence. Probably too much ground to make up, though, as Bradford will come around and finish on the outer. Marcus and Fisse come through 31.7, 31.4. As Victoria Spence will chase Rebecca Bradford down this home stretch. But Bradford will hold her off. Her final time, 2:01 flat, 2:02.16 for Spence. As Marcus and Fisse will come to the line, Fisse will lead this pair. She'll win it with a time of 2 minutes, 0.80. Marcus, 2:01.62. We now have a look at our sixth quartet. This is Carolina Hiller from BC in the inner lane, Dongzhu Zi from China in the outer. Starting behind them is Weiping Gan from China and Lindsay Kent from Manitoba. And this quad is underway. Hiller and Dongzhu Zi down that long opening stretch into the first corner. It looks like they will hold the second start. Sorry, this is Shoutens and McCluskey in this pair. Shoutens with the white armband, McCluskey with the red. They will finish this race on their own. Next pair on the quad will start once they are finished. McCluskey leading the way in this one. See what her first lap time is. McCluskey comes through. Two to go, 29.4, 29.7 for Shoutens. The skaters change lanes every lap, total of three times in this 1500 meter race. The 1500 meter is comparable to the 800 in track running. Depending how you view it, it is a long sprint or a short endurance race. Generally rewards skaters who can take a lot of lactic acid and have a high tight pain tolerance. As McCluskey and Shoutens are now on their last lap, Shoutens coming around the outside is going to pass Abigail McCluskey on this home stretch, and Shoutens will win this race. Her final time, 1:59.97, 2:39 for McCluskey. So now we have the second pair of the fifth quartet. Who will start up next? This is Nana Takahashi from Japan in the inner lane, Nan Sun from China in the outer. As these two skaters are underway now, as they really try to build up that pace in through 200 meters. Takahashi has the lead. Actually, it's Nan Sun coming back in the opening part of that opener. 26.2, 26.3 for Takahashi. As Nan Sun putting both arms on her back in this 1500 meter race. You don't see that very often. Takahashi uses a string around her waist to keep that left arm on her back as they come through 700 meters. First 400 meter times, 28.3 for Nan Sun, 29.4 for Takahashi. The second lap of the 1500 meter is so important. The skaters can continue to skate hard in that second lap and minimize the drop off in lap times between their first and second laps. They are usually on pace for a good time. As Nen Sun is starting to fade, Nana Takahashi coming around the outside. Does she have enough to catch her in the end? These 1500 meter races are always interesting because it's a meeting point between sprinters and long distancers. Nan Sun will take it. 157.75. That's a quick time. 158 for Takahashi. As we now have a look at our sixth pair, Carolina Hiller and Dongzhu Zi, Wai-Ping Gan and Lindsay Kent. As they come through the first 100 meters, Carolina is a sprinter, so expect her opening split in this 15 to be very quick. And she leads her pair through the first 300 meters. Hiller's opening split 26.5, 26.8 for Dongzhu Zi. As her second pair is now underway, this is Kent and Gan. They're picking up the pace through 300. 27.3 for Gan. Kent, 27.4. So a little off the pace of Hiller and Z. As Z will lead through 700 meters. Her split time, 29.2, 30.3 for Hiller. Good race here between Kent and Gan. They're well matched. Lap times, 29.9 for Kent, 30.0 for Gan. Anyone's race with two laps to go in our second pair as Hiller and Z will come through. Z expanding her lead, 30.9 her lap time, 31.9 for Hiller. As Kent now pulling away from Wai-Ping Gan. Now on their bell lap, 31.6 is Kent's lap time. Great drop off from her previous lap time. As Dongzhu Zi looking strong right to the line, her final time, 2 minutes, 0.05. Hiller will finish with a 2:02.20. As our second pair comes into the finishing stretch, Kent driving to the line. She looks strong on this last lap. 2:02.49, her final time. Gan, 2:06.02. This is our seventh quartet. Dan Bai from China. And Jacqueline Bernico from the United States. Another China-US matchup in the second pair. Brianna Kramer and Huiwei Li. This is Bai and Bernico. Through 100. As our second pair is now underway. And Dan Bai opening a huge lead on this opening. 300 meters. 26.3 her opener. 28.5 for Bernico. So Dan Bai gaining 2 seconds. the initial stage of this race. It'll be a long chase for Jacqueline Bernico if she's going to catch her. QY Lee, 26-1. That's a fast opener. Brianna Kramer, 27-2. As Dan Bai continues to lead her pair, 29-8 her lap time. Bernico, 31-8 her time. As Kramer and Lee will come around through 700 meters. Lap times, Lee, 29-3, 29-8 for Kramer. Bell lap now for Dan Bai and Jacqueline Bernico. Dan Bai, 32-63, is carving a big lead over Jacqueline Bernico. 33-6 was her time. As Li Huai hears the bell, 32-1, she's chasing her teammate Dan Bai. 32-0 for Kramer. As Dan Bai now on the finishing stretch of this top 1500 meter race, skating to the line, looking strong. Dan Bai finishes with a final time of 2:03.71. Jacqueline Bernico, 2:08.95. As Brianna Kramer will chase QY Lee down this home stretch, but QY Lee will take it, 2:02.95. 2:04.15 for Kramer. As we now move on to our eighth quartet, this is Rikke Jebsen from Norway in the inner lane. Alison Bates from Great Britain in the outer. Starting behind them is Inga Ann Vassesen from Norway. And Alexandra Ianculescu from Romania. And it looks like we have a brief delay here for ice repair. So the athletes just haven't been called to the line yet. As our ice techs and referees inspect the ice. Skaters skating around before or after the races. That's Carolina Hiller on the forefront. She's smiling. So we are now seven quartets through our ladies' 1500 meters. We will be taking a brief break after quartet 15 for an ice repair. Oh, sorry, for an ice flood. That will be followed by 11 quartets of ladies 1500 meter. Another flood. And then the 1500 meter men. But it looks like we are ready to go here. Ice is inspected and we are ready to hit the start. This is Rikke Jebsen and Alison Bates, Inga Ann Vassesen, and Alexandra Ianculescu. As Jebsen and Bates are off to a clean start. Clean start in the second pair as well. As our first pair is now down the home stretch. This is Jepsen leading the way, 26-7 her opening split, 27-3 for Bates. As Ianculescu and Vasisin come through, it's Ianculescu leading the way, 27-7 her opening time, 27-8 for Vasisin. Ianculescu setting up a great draft on this backstretch. She will use Inga and Vasisin for a bit of a reprieve from that wind. It's sometimes beneficial to use a draft in the backstretch. Sometimes if you're going much faster than your pair, it can actually slow you down. And Kolescu's opening split, 30.3, 30.5 for Vasisin. Jepsen had the fastest first lap, 39.3 was her time, 31.2 for Jepsen on her second lap, 33.7 for Bates. Ianculescu continues to lead Vasisin. We get a look at Rikke Jepsen on her last lap, heading into that final corner. Those legs are burning up as Rikke Jepsen comes down the finishing stretch. Allison Bates way behind her as Rikke Jepsen will finish with a 2:01.16. She raises her hands in celebration. That's a personal best as Allie Bates comes through 2:09.20, her final time. And Alex Ianculescu will win the second pair, her final time, 2:03.44, 2:04.81 for Vasisin. But it was Rikke Jepsen with a 2-second personal best, 2:01. Always fun to watch the pain faces of these skaters after they finish these 1500-meter races. A little bit of Schadenfreude in your morning. Aren't you glad you're sitting at home watching on YouTube? As our next quartet comes up, this is Si Ning Yang and Si Shan Li, both from China. Two teammates racing in the first pair of this quartet. Starting behind them is another Chinese skater, Xian Yu Chen, in the inner lane. Sarah Spence from BC is her pair in the outer. As Si Ning Yang comes through her first 300-meter split, 26.8, 28.1 for Li. As Spence has the lead here through 300 in the second pair. Spence with the blue armband. Her opening split, 27.5, 27.8 for Chen. So Spence setting up a big draft on this first lap. She's going to continue to drive on this first lap of the 1500 meter. Close race so far between Si Shan Li and Si Ning Yang. Yang has the lead, though. See if she can expand that on the next lap. Chen and Spence neck and neck. Now, Si Ning Yang opening a big gap over her teammate. Second lap time, 33.7, 35.1 for Si Shan Li. That's almost 4 seconds off of her previous lap. As Xian Yu Chen has now pulled away from Sarah Spence by a little. Her lap time, 31.2, 32.2 for Spence. And this is Si Ning Yang, who will win her pair, 2:05.77. Si Shan Li will come in with a 2:11.75. As Chen will lead Spence to the line. 202.01 her time, 205.09 for Sarah Spence. Sarah Spence with a 205 is right on her personal best. As we are now moving on to our 10th quartet. Although they are not at the start line, it seems we might have a brief ice repair somewhere on the track. And it looks like we are ready to go at the start. This is Darian O'Neill from the United States in the inner lane. And Véronique Dey from Quebec in the outer. Starting behind them, Julia Roth from Alberta. And Xin Miao Zhang from China. This is O'Neill and Dady underway. Through their first 300 meters, Roth and Zhang at the start line now. They're off and racing. Expect Julia Roth to open very quick as Dady comes through her opening split. 27.4, that's quick. 28.3 for O'Neill, as Véronique Dey will go over the top of her pair on that backstretch. O'Neill has some ground to make up. Véronique Dey looking quite dynamic. This is O'Neill. Sorry, this is Roth and Zhang. 26.7 for both skaters. Quick openers as well. So who has the legs between Roth and Zhang? They both had the same opener. Who's got the endurance to close out this 15? As Dady and O'Neill come through, 30.5 for Véronique Dady, her lap time. O'Neill, 31.3. Zhang opening a lead over Julia Roth. 29.9 was her opening split. 31.01 initial lap time for Roth. As we hit the bell lap for Véronique Dady and Darian O'Neill. Dady still leading, but O'Neill is gaining ground. 1.5 seconds to make up over the last 400 meters. Should be an interesting finish as Zhang comes through. Her lap time, 33.3, 33.2 for Roth. Final stretch now for Véronique Dady and Darian O'Neill as Dady will drive to the line. Her final time, 205.21, 205.67 for O'Neill. As Zhang will come to the line. Last lap of the 1500, always so painful. Her final time, 205.09. That's the fastest of the quad, 206.64 for Roth. As we look at our 11th quartet, this is Gabrielle Sanson from Saskatchewan in the inner lane, and Marie Gulbrandsen from Norway in the outer. Behind them, Alexa Scott from Manitoba, and Danielle Wallish from Alberta. Pay attention to those armbands. They help you pick out the skaters on the ice. So underway now for Sanson and Gulbrandsen. The first straightaway in the 1500 meters, especially for the inner lane, is the longest straight line the skaters will do after a start. They actually start a little bit into the corner as Gudbrandsen leads the first pair, 27-01 her opening split, 27-3 for Sanson. Gabrielle Sanson has to let up a little bit to let Gudbrandsen by her on that backstretch. The skater coming from the outer lane has the right of way. So they were side by side. Sanson had to let up a little bit to let her pair through. Gudbrandsen's first lap time, 29.9, 31.7 for Sanson. As they are now through that corner, 500 meters to go here for Anne-Marie Gudbrandsen from Norway with one lap remaining. 31.84, her lap time. Sanson, 33.91. We come through, coaches yelling them on the backstretch. Long track speed skating is one of the few sports where the coaches are allowed on the same surface as the skaters. The coaches strap on skates and skate down that backstretch, encouraging on their skaters. Gudbrandsen will finish with a 202.98. Sanson, 209.28. Earlier this morning, Béatrice Lamarche skated a 158.13. That was 3/100ths faster than the fastest ever Canadian junior time set by Callie Crist a few years ago. So Béatrice Lamarche breaking the Canadian junior record by a hair this morning. So the ice is quick here at the Oval as our next pair is underway. They'll be looking for quick times. This is Alexa Scott in the inner lane. Danielle Walsh in the outer. Their opening splits 27-6 for Scott, 28-2 for Walsh. Both skaters looking great on that backstretch. They're looking for easy, consistent, and efficient strides. Both skaters doing a good job of that, staying nice and low and long. What tends to happen as these skaters get tired is that their strides will shorten as their muscles tighten up. They also start to skate a little bit higher, which causes them to hit more wind, more air, slows them down. Really important in these 1500 meter races that the skaters focus and stay low as they come around with one lap to go. Alexa Scott, her lap time, 33.5, 33.4 for Walsh. So Walsh starting to go a bit quicker. She has a second to make up though. As they're on their last backstretch, crossing over for the last time into the final corner. Danielle Walsh chasing Alexa Scott. And Alexa Scott will come out of that corner. It looks like she will hold off Walsh on this home stretch. Scott and Walsh will finish up. Times of 208.64, Walsh 209.40. This is our next group of skaters, Thea Floyten from Norway in the inner lane, and Namaste Harris Gauthier from Quebec in the outer. Starting behind them, MK Huser from Germany is in the inner. Caroline Gingras from Quebec in the outer. So Floyten and Harris Gauthier underway through their first 100 meters as Huser and Gingras are off the line now as well. Namaste Gauthier. Harris Gauthier will come through. 28.3, her opening split. 28.8 for Floyten. Gauthier will be setting up a good draft on that backstretch as Gingras will lead the way over Huser. Her 300-meter split, 27.9, 28.5 for Huser. As they cross over on the backstretch, skater from the outer lane moves to the inner. Inner lane moves to the outer. As Gingras was bearing down on MK Huser on that backstretch. Seven 700 meters in, Harris Gauthier has the lead over Thea Floyten. So both Quebec skaters leading their pairs through 700 meters. Look out there, MK Huser coming on as Namaste Harris Gauthier will come through with one lap to go. Lap time of 31.9, 33.0 for Floyten. As MK Huser has made a comeback on Caroline Gingras. Should be an interesting last lap as she leads the way. 400 meters to go, 33.5 her lap time, 34.15 for Gingras, as Harris Gauthier will win this race in commanding fashion. Her final time, 2:03.64. Namaste Harris Gauthier with an excellent race, 2:08.56 for Floyten. Namaste Harris Gauthier skating a 4-second personal best as MK Huser will take the second race. 2:08.20 her final time. Gingras 2:10.01. And good time there for MK Huser. We have a look at our 13th quad. This is Brooklyn McDougall from Alberta in the inner lane. Taylor White from Ontario in the outer. Starting behind them, Olivia Moyes from Saskatchewan and Hannah Clark from the Northwest Territories. As all four skaters are underway now in this 1500-meter race, 27.2 for McDougall, 27.8 for White. As Moyes and Clark come through, Clark with a fast opener, 27.6, Moyes 29.0. So Hannah Clark will come over the top of Olivia Moyes on this first lap. Moyes has some ground to make up as Taylor White leads the first pair. 30.9, her opening lap time. 31.7 for McDougall. Hannah Clark's first lap time, 30.3. She leads the quad. Olivia Moyes, 33.1. Always interesting to watch those lap times as the skaters come through. The skaters will invariably fade in the 1500 meter. It's part of the strategy. But you always want to see by how much will they fade, as Taylor White will come out of that corner side by side with Brooklyn McDougall. McDougall will tuck in behind her, Taylor White having the right of way, as they're on their last lap now. And Taylor White will come out of that corner with the lead. She will take this pair as she comes down the last 50 meters, Taylor White to the line, her final time, 207.40. McDougal right behind her, 208.89. Hannah Clark, who's on a good race here. See if she can keep this next lap time under 35. 34.19, her final time, 204.39. Respectable finish for the short tracker. 212.49 for Moyes. That was our 13th quad. Up next, quad 14. This is Katja Lutz from Switzerland in the inner lane. She's paired with Marie Bakken-Haugli from Norway in the outer. Starting a half lap behind them, Ida Sanderud from Norway and Connie Kapak from Alberta. As Lutz and Haugli underway here through their first 100 meters, Sanderud and Kapak just off the line now, although there was a false start, so they will be called into the inside of the track. Lutz and Haugli will finish this race on their own, as Lutz opens with an opening lap time of 27.9, 29.5 for Haugli. As they come through, Katja Lutz is chasing a personal best of 2.10. 2 minutes and 10 seconds, her personal best. See if she can beat that here today. Marie Bakken-Haugli is chasing a 209. As these skaters come around, one lap to go for the first pair of this 14th quad. Katja Lutz and Marie Bakken-Haugli. Lutz leads the way. Her lap time, 33.8. 33.8 for Haugli. Both skaters doing well on that second lap. See how they can close off this race as they switch lanes on the backstretch. Haugli has some ground to make up, but she's looking strong on this last corner. Too little, too late. As Katja Lutz will come to the line and win this pair, her final time, 209.85. That's a personal best. Marie Bakken-Haugli. 210.83. So we have a look at our next pair, Ida Sanderud and Connie Kapak. There was a false start in this pair as they tried to start behind the previous pair in a quartet. But they are off cleanly the second time. This is Sanderud and Kapak. Ida Sanderud's personal best is a 2:10. This in the 1500 meter. Kapak a 2:09. So Connie Kapak chasing 208. They're opening splits. 28.7, 28.8. Neck and neck through 300 meters. These skaters will be aiming for an initial lap of 31 seconds or 32 seconds. Let's see what they can do. Still a tight one here. Down the home stretch, Sanderud's opening split, 32.7, Kapak, 33.2. So Ida Sanderud setting up a big draft on this backstretch. And she will just skate right by Connie Capak as she crosses over into the inner lane. Ida Sanderud showing grit here on this second lap. So one lap to go now for Sanderud and Capak. Lap times 35.0 for Sanderud, Capak 35.7. As they're now on their final lap. The hardest lap in speed skating, the last lap of the 1500 meter. When everything in your body tells you that you should quit. Connie Capak making a late comeback here in this race. She's going to make it tight at the line. Sanderud will take it, though. 2:13.22, her final time. Connie Capak, 2:13.40. As we now move on to our final quartet here before the break. This is Danielle Dzumuchel from New Brunswick and Kayla McNeely from Alberta. Dzumuchel and McNeely underway. Paquet and Labidie starting behind them. This is two Quebecers starting in the final pair before the flood. Laurence Paquet, Myriam Labidie. As Danielle Dzumuchel leads the way through the first 300 meters, her opening split 29.2, 29.7 for McNeely. And they're on their first lap. This is Labidie in the outer lane, 28.0. That's the fastest opener of the quartet. She's bearing down on Laurence Paquet on that backstretch. As McNeely trails Dzumuchel, 32.61 for McNeely, 32.40 for Dzumuchel. So Dzumuchel pulling away just a little bit as Paquet and Labidie will come around. Their first lap times, Labidie 31.1, 32.5 for Paquet. As Myriam Labidie putting together a quick race here. Bell lap now for Dzumuchel McNeely. Dzumuchel's lap time, 33.8. McNeely, 33.4. So Kayla McNeely bearing down on Danielle Dzumuchel. She has her in her sights on this backstretch. And she has the last inner. She could complete the comeback. Labidie continues to lead Laurence Paquet with one lap to go. As they're on their final stretch now, McNeely in the last lap will take this race. 2:10.56 for Kayla McNeely, 2:11.61 for Danielle Dzumuchel. So Kayla McNeely with a strong finish. She was losing after 1,100 meters, last 400 meters, she came from behind and won that race. As Myriam Labidie took it 2:08.68. That was fast. Paquet, 2:12.53. And so this wraps up the first block of ladies' 1,500 meters. We will have a brief flood break now as we had a look at our leaderboard. A reminder to tweet or Instagram at the Olympic Oval, #finallyfinale, to see your pictures or tweets up on the live webcast or on the screens at the Oval. I know you're having fun at finale. Tweet to to show those smiles. We'll be back at 10:10 with more action.
Thank you.
point you mentioned where they can find the list of skaters and stuff. Should I put that in credits?
Oh, maybe. I mean, it's like if you went to the Oracle website, what's that?